thermal properties or thermal expansion. Okay, next one, thermal expansion. This is, I think, my fifth topic. I think this is fifth topic in this chapter. Thermal expansion. Okay, in the thermal expansion, then what we can say, thermal expansion means thermal isotope. What should be there? Pressure should be there, volume should be there, temperature should be there. Then expansion means it should be, length should be increased. Then we can say that is the expansion. Okay, here, suppose when the system will be, expansion will happen. Suppose let us take, suppose one bottle is there, already it is sealed with metallic. Suppose let us consider one bottle is there, that is sealed with metallic. What happens if you open after 2-3 months? Sometimes you are unable to open that lid. Why? Because that lid is tightly fixed with that bottle. So in that case, what we can do? Simply take the bottle and keep in the hot water sometime. Then what happen? Then you are able to open that lid. What happen? The lid is absorbed heat from the water. Then what happen? Automatically inside the solid, the particle arrangement tightly little bit loosed. Due to that, we are able to open that lid. So in that case, what happen? The automatically, automatically the metal length will be increased. Due to that, there are some expansions. There are different types of expansions will be exist. Or else we can say, suppose in those days, then suppose if you want to fix this bullock cart will be there. The bullock cart will made by the total, that is wood only. So that wheel contain that iron part total. How they will fix that that person? Suppose first he will eat that the total iron part. Then what happened? He eat so much that should looks like a red hot coal. Up to that much temperature he will eat. Then in that case, what happened? Automatically the iron expansion will happen. Then again he will make a circle. Then again he will fix into that wheel. So after some time, what happened? Already it has the more temperature, he fixed that iron into fixed to the wheel. So then the total fixed, what happen? There is no more heat. What happen? The automatically the iron absorb coldness. Why? Because here heat is there, surroundings heat is less. What happen? Automatically heat transfers will be there from one place to another place. You know that heat is transferred from always lower to higher hot body to next to low temperature, or else in one sense we can say the heat is transferring from higher temperature to lower temperature. Then here there are three types of expansion will be exist. Okay, suppose first one is linear expansion coefficient. Okay, suppose if you increase the temperature, let us take, if you just now I said, if you take iron, if you give the temperature to this iron, then what happen? The dimension will be changed. Dimension means shape and value and area. So dimension will be shape, dimension will changes means, dimension means that may be length, that may be area, that may be volume. Under the dimension, dimension will change. If you give temperature, you are increasing the temperature to the, if you are giving some temperature to the object, what happen? Automatically dimension change. Dimension change means, okay, what are under the dimension, what all things may come? First one, it may, length may change, next area may change, next value may change. So that's why we are saying linear expansion coefficient. Next, Arial expansion coefficient. Next, volume, expansion, coefficient. These are the three types of expansion will be exist. Okay, linear expansion coefficient denoting with alpha letter. Next, Arial expansion coefficient denoted with beta. Next, volume expansion coefficient denoted with gamma. Okay, next we are going to study one by one. So first we are going to study about the linear expansion coefficient. What is the linear expansion coefficient? Okay, for this now I am considering, let us consider let us consider L length of rod we are having. So what happened? We are giving some energy. So now I am going to draw the diagram. This is the length of a rod. Okay, if you supply the heat, what happen automatically? Like this did happen. So what happen here? Automatically the length will be increased. That how much we don't know. That's why we can take this is the delta L. Okay, linear expansion of coefficient denoted by L. So let us consider L length of the rod. Now I have supplied some energy. Okay, how much energy? So which energy? Temperature. That how much you are giving? Delta T you are giving. Change temperature. You are changing. So always you are giving the temperature. Then what happened? Automatically length also increasing. From this what we can write? Length of the rod. This is small change in temperature. Okay, this is what we can say, that is the small change in temperature. So from this what we can write, then formula we can write. See, delta L by L directly proportional to the then delta T. Okay, length coefficient is directly proportional to the changing temperature. Okay, this is length coefficients, change in length coefficient directly proportional to the temperature delta T. Then what we can write? Delta L by L is equal to which coefficient we can take? Delta T. So what I want, actually I want alpha value. Then what I can write? Alpha delta L by L is equal to delta T. Here what is there? Alpha is there. Then what we can say? Alpha is equal to delta L by L then delta T. Okay, small change in temperature means from where to where? L is equal delta L means L2 minus L1 divided by L2 into T2 minus T1. This is, we can say, linear expansion coefficient alpha. Next, second one. Next, Arial expansion coefficient. Arial expansion means, let us consider, that is, suppose I am considering one black. Okay, what is the block of area? Means, let us consider this is A. Now, okay, now I am supplying some energy to this black. Then what happen? Definitely it will be expanding. So how much may be there? This is delta A. So then what we can write? Delta A, this is the limit or coefficient of area is directly proportional to what we can say, this is also delta T. Why? Because why you are writing always delta T means you are, when you are giving some temperature to this block, then only this will be expand. Then we can say that is the expansion. But what, where is the expansion is happening here? In the area. Then we can say this is the areal expansion coefficient. Okay, here what is the constant areal expansion coefficient? Beta delta A by A is equal to, what is that? Beta into delta T. So which one I need? I need the coefficient of areal. Then what we can write? Beta is equal to delta A by A into delta T. Delta A means what we can write? Area from where to where. If you consider this is A1, A2, then what we can write here? Beta is equal to next A2 minus A1 by A1 into T2 minus T1. This is the expansion of, areal expansion of coefficients.